Back up on my bullshit, back up on the scene. Done dealing with you, don't know how to deal with me. Done fucking with you, don't know how to love me. Done dealing with you, so I'm back. It seemed like I get so much and don't get nothing back. I really thought it was love, but you're so fucking whack. Always get caught up in love, but I am done with that. I can't get caught up in love, so now I'm, yeah.
Yeah, Cortez Elliott Wilson. The honor and pleasure. Jhené Aiko.
Thank you. Thank you for having me. I'm good.
You have a really anticipated album. We've been waiting a long time for. CHILOMBO, I'm about to listen to it finally?
Yes.
Is it time?
It's time.
How does it feel like to finally get this out to the world?
It feels amazing. I've been working on it for a while. Put my heart, blood, sweat, and tears into this one, as I do all of them, but I'm super excited for everybody to hear it.
In the real life, why right here, man? A little Flossin' Slossin' style?
Yeah. Flossie Slossin' is my other alias that I go
Flossie
by.
Flossie Slossin'.
You will catch me on Slossin' in the Rose Gold.
And you driving herself. She ain't playing no games today, right?
Exactly.
Jhené, I'm on it. Let's go. Car test title.
Let's get it.
Bitch, see you with your ex, I see you still about your old ways. Might just see him for the weekend, you say that's a cold play. I be feeling triggered,
I saw you had a cool tweet where you said, like, I just wrote down all the lyrics to the free flows that are CHILOMBO.
Yes.
What did you mean exactly when you wrote that?
Basically, went to the big island of Hawaii. Okay. And me and the producers that I work with, my keyboard player, Brian from the Fisticuffs, I had an engineer. We set up this house.
Okay.
Like a big jam session. Like every day was a jam session. And so all of these songs are free flows. I call them free flows and not freestyles, because it's not so much like what your typical freestyle would be, where you're like, you get on the beat and you just.
Yeah.
It's not like a rapper.
Yeah.
You know, because
the group could just be playing for 3 minutes.
Exactly. So, yeah. It's more of a jam.
Jam session-y.
More jam session-y. And so sometimes it's just melody. Sometimes it's words, and it's all of it all at once. And so all of these songs came from those jam sessions. And I call it free flow because the big island is, well, all of the Hawaii islands obviously were formed from a volcano. And the lava flow. You know, I just relate to it because it's just like,
yeah,
it's something very cool about.
So the surroundings kind of inspired.
For sure, 100%.
She knows.
Like the way I wink at you.
Yeah.
I can never have a hater born inside my body. Nope. I just like it better when my girl do her Pilates. I wanna dress you up and have you fresher than the stylist. Think about any drama when your body.
That sounds like a real collaboration. Like, you know what I mean? Sometimes when people's like, so-and-so's on the record, it's like,
yeah.
But even the way the voices are blended, like, there's so much great structure to that record. It's sort of like everybody is showcased with you at the center, but everyone gets their showcase. And like here in Future, you know, everybody looks like people that would love the Future side where he sings.
Yes.
You know what I mean? Was that something that attracted you to be like, let's capture that part of him?
Yeah, for sure. Me and Miguel did the song Ho on my Selling Souls mixtape back in, what was that, 2011?
Yeah, yeah.
And we were having a jam session, me and the band. And when I started singing to it, I automatically started singing the Ho hook. Mm. And I was like, I might as well just do that, because I don't think that song ever got its shine.
Okay, like it deserved. Okay.
And you know, it was on a mixtape, so which is not on, which I'm trying working
it's not on.
Not
on those DSPs. Come on, Jhené.
I'm working on it. But so I was like, let me go ahead and put this on the album.
Yeah.
Do some new verses. Yeah. Put a new feature on there, because we had on the mixtape, we had actually took a Gucci Mane verse from like another song. Mm. And like in true mixtape style, we kind of like just were ripping stuff. Yeah. And so I was like, who else? And then we were like, Future, yes, perfect. And when he got the song, he added so much to it. Like, it was perfect. It was perfect.
No. 10,000 memories.
Yeah. Thinking back on some good times we had with some bad people, like, I should have saw she was see-through or he was evil, like, I wasted my good experience with these people, like, guess it was meant to be, you was teaching me life.
I always had this concept sort of in my mind about, who do I tell that I miss a person who is gone, because usually, you know, when a person's mm-hmm. here, you can call them, you can text them and say, I miss you. But when there's a person who's passed away, there's no one you can tell. So that kind of is like a part of what this song is about, is explaining that to the person that is here. Like, look, I know what it's like to not be able to actually tell a person I miss you or I want to see you. So, you know, when I tell you I want to see you or that I miss you, it means something different, because I'm coming from a place of like knowing and loss, like real loss of someone that you love.
And Nas, what made you, just on an artistic level, bring Nas into the fold on that joint?
So the beat was just so like hip hop to
that
me.
Bop, yeah, New York, that bop, yeah.
And
classic New York kind of neo soul-y kind of vibe.
Exactly, exactly. And it doesn't need changes or anything. You can, for me, I could just listen to it like on a loop. And I just heard Nas's voice on it. Yeah. And I asked him, and he literally came the next day.
Wow.
And pretty much did his part like that. And that made me, while he was recording his part,
mm-hmm.
and this always happens with rappers for me, like when they put their feature down,
mm-hmm.
I get inspired and I get
like, I got another verse.
Yeah. And then I was like, oh, hold on, I have another verse. I have more that I want to say. I have more that I can do. After I saw, you know, I was inspired to switch up a melody and say some more things.
Bounce back, that's an echo. Fuck them all. Not sexually, disrespectfully. Instead of catching me, all that's left of me is tying them off.
Jhené, I gotta be honest with you.
Yeah. Okay.
This isn't what I expected. I thought we were gonna get like, you know.
There's 20 songs, so.
But you are hitting like you got some collabs, like some dope, you know, to the hip hop heads, like some dope collabs.
Yeah.
Like, I think a lot of people say, well, a lot of your pockets more like, you know, even like some of the mantra stuff you put out, like, you know, like it's kind of be a lot more slow tempo stuff, but it's a lot of diversity here.
It's a very diverse album. I'm a very diverse person.
Absolutely.
CHILOMBO is a very unique name.
So it's all
name.
Sizes, CHILOMBO.
Yeah, for sure. I didn't write anything down. That's why when I tweeted that, you know, I just wrote down all the lyrics. It was
you said the realest shit I ever wrote.
Yeah, because when I wrote it, it's 20 songs. And as I was, you know, listening back to what I free float, and I was typing it out, I'm like, oh, okay, this is, okay, there's some bars here. I know what I like to hear, and I want to be able to listen to my music and love it as if it were, you know, another artist. Because I feel like you can, because it's me, I could get tired of it easy mm-hmm. and be like, oh, okay, I know what I sound like, or I was there when I made the song.
Yeah.
But I love to get songs to a point where I can listen to them myself and just be detached, that it's, you know, from the fact that it's me.
Yeah. It's been a long night, long life, long time fighting. Let out a long sigh, alright, why am I trying? Cause look at how far you have come, and look at all that you have going. Look at who you
tired.
Are.
Born tired. Yeah, I was born tired.
Why that title? Like, what's the difference here?
Oh, because I think that was always a concept in my mind too. Just like born tired. Like, I think one day I just came up with that in my mind. Like, I feel like I was born tired. Like when I see pictures of me as a little kid, I just look like, I'm over it. And just not over it, but like I've seen this before.
Yeah.
You know, like maybe I'm on like my 12th life and I'm kind of like, you know, for me, I listen to that song as just inspiration to like keep going, you know, through my exhaustion.
It's almost a test of your strength. Right?
Yeah, exactly. Because before, like we did it acoustic when we came up with the song, it was like kind of like a drag, but I was like, actually this song should be like inspirational. Mm. And like even, I feel like a lot of people feel tired, you know? Every day you wake up, you go to do your job, you go home, you like.
It's the opposite of what everybody celebrates, which is hard work and work ethic.
Yeah, exactly, exactly.
But the other side is, you're tired. Like
you're
weight, it's a weight that comes with all that stuff.
Exactly.
Why was it important to name this project? When you say CHILOMBO, which is the last name, what's the significance behind that? Like, what's CHILOMBO. The power behind it to call it CHILOMBO?
Well, it's my last name, which is me. You know, a lot of people think Aiko, is my last name, but Aiko is actually one of my middle names.
Okay.
My full name is Jhené Aiko Ifuru CHILOMBO. So my dad, in his 20s, he changed his full name to Karamo CHILOMBO.
That's a great name right there.
It's a great, powerful name. My dad is a doctor. He's super smart. He's someone that I wasn't really close to when I was a kid. But as I got older, I really started to see that I was his daughter and definitely got a lot of who I am from him. Growing up, I knew that he had changed his last name, so I didn't feel connected to it. I was like, people can't pronounce it. Everyone asked me, what does it mean? And I don't know anything because this is a name that he just sort of gave himself. Mm-hmm. And I was kind of embarrassed by my last name. Then I got older and I started to really just feel connected to it and feel like this is me, this is who I am.
You cannot define me. I can tell you're trying, but you've gotta find me.
So satisfying. I'm really proud of that one because I'm like, oh, I played everything on there. Like, oh, what are you playing? I'm like, oh, it's like.
Just everything.
It's like, yeah, just everything singing on a day. People love to try to put artists in a box.
Yeah.
And it's like, I feel like true artists, true creators, always evolving. I, for one, feel like I have so many layers to me and I will express every single one of them, you know?
And that's even with your foundation selling soul that comes from. You never wanted to sell yourself or try to prove yourself and follow these paths to what it means to be a recording artist signed to a label. Like, you seem like you've still always done it your own way.
Always. I do a lot more with my vocal range but I'm always like, oh, I'm not gonna try that live because I'm like, I don't wanna fuck up. But that one really, I really wanted to try new things. Yeah. And of course, John Legend is an amazing singer. So I had finished the song, done the song, sent it to him. And he sent me a verse back, right? Like that, and I was like, oh wow, the legend himself.
You did it, man. It's worth the wait.
Thank you.
CHILOMBO passed the contest.
Did it pass it?
It passed it easily. Jhené, thank you so much. And you said before we get out of here, let's set out from beginning to end. We gave you a couple tracks, but the full experience.
But it's 20 for 2020, and 20 plus 20 plus 20 is 60, which is my hood. No.
Slauson, baby. Contest title. Jhené's back.
And it's everything to me.